In this class, we are going to discuss about dual slope or integrating type ADC. In the last classes, we discussed about so many ADCs flash type ADC, flash or parallel type ADC, and so many ADCs we discussed. That means counter type, all these we discussed in the last classes. So now we are going to discuss one of the accurate ADCs among all ADCs, that is dual slope or integrating type ADC. The block diagram for this, the circuit for dual slope or integrating type ADC is this. You can observe a switch which is positioning to V in and V reference. So please keep in mind, when you are taking your V in and V reference, those must be in opposite polarity. For example, if you take in your input voltage in positive polarity, you need to take your reference in negative polarity. So when you are designing your dual slope or integrating type ADC, your input voltage and reference voltage must be in opposite polarity, as opposite direction. So now you can see this switch is controlled by this control circuit. So whatever it may be, here you can observe a voltage because of this connection. And whenever V naught greater than 0, then only your output here is equivalent to 1. That means, so here you can observe this V naught is given to, the output from this circuit is given to positive terminal or anode of this op amp. So now here this negative terminal is grounded. Grounded means 0. Whenever this positive voltage is greater than this 0, then only output of this particular op amp is equivalent to 1. So here whenever V naught greater than 0, then I am considering like output. So this output is equivalent to 1. Otherwise, that means V naught less than 0, in this case the output here is equivalent to 0. So now here you can observe an AND gate which will pass this clock signal, which will controls this clock signal. Here you can observe AND gate is given with this output and this clock. So you know the property of AND gate: whenever both inputs of are high, then only output is equivalent to high. For example, you are having this clock signal like this. If you want to pass this clock signal as it is, you need to provide always this output is equivalent to 1. For example, that output is equivalent to 0. In any case, then definitely this clock is not going to output of AND gate. Why? Because 0 into any clock or any signal is equivalent to 0 for a AND gate. So to pass this clock to output of AND gate, you need to get output here as equivalent to 1. That means always V naught must be greater than 0 to get your output is equal to 1. This will gives you the clock pass to output of AND gate. So now whenever clock pass it to output of AND gate, that means whenever V naught is greater than 0, obviously the counter is going to count this output pulse. So whenever V naught greater than 0, here output will become 1. Whenever this is equal to 1, clock passes to output of AND gate, that clock is counted by N bit counter. So initially the counter starts from 000. You can take 3 bit counter, for example. If you are doing, so where you are giving your analog input means here you are giving your analog input. So if your analog input is greater than your reference, then that will connect to V in, otherwise it's connecting to V reference. So like that. So here, if you want to give, if you are giving your analog input there, here you are getting your digital output of your ADC. That means, for example, if you take a 3 bit counter, your output will be 3 bit digital data. If you consider 4 bit counter, it can count only up to 4 bits. That means 4 ones, up to 4 ones. So here initially counter having 0, to count it, to change from all zeros to all ones, that means maximum counting, it will take 2 power n minus 1 into t clock cycles. In the same way, to for this total process, it will take some time t1. So total time of this dual or integrating type ADC is equivalent to T1 plus this counter time is 2 power n minus 1 into T. So in the same way, this T1 is also equivalent to 2 power n minus 1 into T plus 2 power n minus 1 into T. So you can simply write this like, so this is equivalent to 2 into 2 power n minus 1 into T. So here I am writing like this, I am just multiplying to inside, 2 into 2 power n, I am writing like 2 power n plus 1 minus 2 into T. Just I am neglecting this 2 as 2 power n plus 1 is a large number, then nearly the conversion time of this particular ADC is equivalent to 2 power n plus 1 T. So you use so many ADCs, like it's taking 2 power n cycles. If you take in counter type ADC, it's taking 2 power n cycles, and some ADC is taking n cycles. Some flash type ADC, it's taking parallel type ADC, it's taking only single clock cycle. But it takes 2 power n plus 1 time cycles. So this T is nothing but clock period. So how much duration your clock is having, that duration you need to consider here, where n is equivalent to number of bits. Now for example, if same data is given, that means same analog data is given for different ADCs, the accuracy is high in dual slope or integrating type ADC, but it's very slow because you can see the conversion time. Conversion time is 2 power n plus 1 into T, whereas for other ADCs that's taking only n cycles. For some ADCs it's taking 2n time cycles, for some ADCs it's taking single time cycle, like that it's taking. But for this it is 2 power n plus 1 time cycles, means it's very 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 slow. The advantage of this particular ADC is accuracy. When you are having accuracy applications, then you need to use this, but it's take very large time, that means it's very 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 slow. For example, if you want, even though it's slow, if you want accuracy, then you can use this dual slope or integrating type ADC. So that means it's very accurate compared to all ADCs, and it's very slow compared to all ADCs. So the option is yours, that where you need to use this or where you can't use this. So in next class, you will discuss sigma delta ADC.